was easy enough.
All right, you lousy lot. Get your arses on board. She's ready to sail.
You heard the captain. Clive?
Uh-oh. What? He's still alive?
But I thought he was.
Wow.
Confounded. Then it is as I feared.
Ultima?
Sleipnir is no man, but a creation of Odin.
What? There's more of him?
Phoenix's fiery fundament. Have you no normal enemies?
Oh, shoot.
Up for another round? Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield? A boy, there was a time people called me the Executioner. Or was it my axe? No matter, head will roll all the same.
Mate, new plan! You leave, we follow!
Follow? Swimming, are you?
This will only take a moment, I hope.
Have care, my friends. It is not blood that runs through in these veins. These foes will not fall easily.
But they will.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I brought one!
What? You mean to tell me you use that thing to cut wood? Oh my gosh. Uncle Byron is quite the character, I will tell you that.
Unless you have a better one.
Well, I've already killed at least five of the bastards.
Fuck it. Let's do the lot.
Just like that scene from that cheesy vampire 1980s movie, Bright Night. Almost stuck the landing. Enterprise escaped.
Now, mate!
All right, engine!
Analdia Naro.
What do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine? Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Brandalar can provide them.
So he's going for reinforcements?
Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back.
Oh, careful. Hopefully it's not the water at your back.
Cheerio.
Fare thee well, Uncle.
Do keep up, my boy.
Well, we can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it.
Oh, Dion. He really must be mad if he's going somewhere that safe. Find your strength again.
What have I done?
That wasn't your fault, Dion. Ah, oh, the medicine girl!
My lord.
The Dark Sea. The Enterprise.
There's a lot of sea between here and Walud. But any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the Narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehear.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I say we do as she tells.
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours.
I don't think we caught up to them. I think they came to us.
Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Do you feel that?
All hands! Battle stations!
Does this ship even have weapons?
Let's see what this girl can do.
I guess we are sailing towards them, or maybe they were waiting for us to catch up. I think I have a feeling what's about to happen. I saw like a minor clip of Odin versus Phoenix.
One leads, so does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold. Fascinating. Then, there is naught my blade cannot sever.
I just want to know why his armor looks like that. Instead of, you know, what his armor looks like when he's fully Odin.
Great Gregor's gas!
Whew, that was close. For you, Jill.
It's now or never.
I'll find her.
Uh-oh. Gav, get out of here. Doing in times like these. Through the maelstrom.
Where did you hide her, Barnabas?
Ah!
at last. You're going to die.
Oh, we found her.
Get back.
Clive, how did you?
I'll explain later. Hands. Can you walk?
Out of here, I can.
I don't think that's a good sign.
Stand still!
Phoenix. Are you not the dominant of fire? I see naught before me but a guttering flame.
honest then.
Those mithril engines to good use.
But to where?
You. What did you do to Joshua?
Phoenix? Oh, I expect he will survive. This consciousness in which you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black. And all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake.
Not if we remove the cause of this misery. Not if we destroy the last of the Mother Crystals and restore balance to the world.
Come. Do you truly think it's so simple? The blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Naught, that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord.
Keep it. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice.
Ever led astray by your blind resolve.
Now, it is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate. However much it may hurt.
Get as far away as you can.
Clive, no.
Trust me, Jill.
last meeting, you have grown much. Yet as a vessel, I fear my lord will still find you lacking.
I know in this fight we can't really beat him, but it seems like we're doing pretty good for what's happening so far. My ability? Oh, shit. Stop that?
You would yield so soon.
Never.
Life.
Come on.
Do you not see? Your iron will weighs you down, dragging you ever further from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos. Who are we? What are the dominants? The breath of the Creator still warm on our lips. We carry his light that we might guide the masses in his name. We are but mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you. The power we wield is his. And yet, every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being. It breaks us. It unmakes us. That its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The Icon. It is too much for even his chosen few. Apart from you, Mythos. You wield the might of many, yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that we dominants are a means to an end. We were created for you, that you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose.
Which is?
To feed. As you would know, could you only look beyond the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of volition shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, and shall see them restored to their proper forms.
And what exactly would that be?
Why, loyal servants to God? No.
Manners, Lord Rossfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn everyone Akashic?
Not turn, Mythos. Turn back. For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills. It is time they return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation? And abandon everything we hold dear?
We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms. Not yours, and not your gods.
With every defiant expression of your will, the tighter the chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use.
Clive!
See, it's about the...
The faster it binds you to the remaining dominance, the stronger your hunger will become. Until it leads you back to the only answer there ever was. Mayhap not by the path my master intended, but back all the same.
Ash is not far. I could freeze a path.
You're in no fit state.
Probably not, but I can try. Don't look back!
Clive Festin. This just keeps getting better and better by the second, don't it? Of light impulse. Shadow Coast, Western Ash.
I hope the others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Jill. And they will have seen the ice. Lead. We need only wait till dawn. This is the second time Barnabas has bested me. I'm powerless against him.
Then maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master. Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? But do you really know me? If what Barnabas said was true, then I'm more monster than man. And each time I summon the flames from within, I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for, of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You killed for those you love.
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so alone. Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving. Provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
Jill. Are you sure? If this is what you want, then...
give you the strength to bear it alone.
But I'm not alone. These burdens I carry, my sins, my pain, my sorrow, I see now that they are all a part of me. I promise you, Jill. hate this fate. Find a way to save each other.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I know. I never thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
There it is. I sang corrected. What a beautiful scene. Really spoke to my soul. The dialogue and all. So this is Ash. Ah, there they are. Morning, boy.
What of Barnabas? Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough. Whether we like it or not.
Yeah.
Besides, there is something we must do first.
Destroy the Mother Crystal of Walud.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last mother crystal.
The Einherja is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her. But they know we're coming now. We'll need a plan. And a damn good one at that.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Wait. We just got here! Promise, trophy earned. Here. Ugh. Hello.
Mid says Odin split the sea in two. She's always been partial to a tall tale. But there's tall, and then there's tall.
I struggle to believe it myself.
I see your uncle isn't with you.
He stayed with the Enterprise. After our brush with the Einherja, she was in urgent need of repair. And my uncle knows a shipwright in Randalar. We're to join him there when we're ready to sail for Ash.
You sure that's wise? Last I heard, the place was still overrun with a Kashyyyk.
Show me a city where that isn't true. Ultima's plague is spreading.
We're running out of time, aren't we? We've done our best to shore up the hideaway. I doubt a few planks will stop what's coming. Still, we'll keep at it. Every little helps, I suppose.
Let's hope so.
Across the narrow. The power of ice. Clive has claimed a portion of Icon Shiva's essence, attuning with Shiva. Yeah.
I should visit Joshua. Assuming Tony will allow it.
Yeah, I know. Gotta make sure I get all these side quests taken care of before we officially move.
Don't tell me we've run out of passages.
What do I owe the honor? What's that for you, dear?
Iceberg.
No scratches, right?
Oh, Yote's here. Really?
Covered in nicks and lumps.
Yeah, that's right. Joshua sent her here yesterday.